We live in a world where human wants are never satisfied. Billions of tons of coal are pulled out of the ground by excavators, bagging machines, and then loaded into dump trucks. In 2017, coal made up 27% of the world's energy supply. 3/4 of the steel produced today uses coal. Coal is also used in making ingredients for products around us, such as wood curing chemicals, shampoos, and also rubber products that we incorporate in our daily livelihoods. And as for power generation, Africa obtains approximately 92.7% of its electricity from coal. And for a country like South Africa, it will be plunged into darkness, as coal accounts for almost 70% of the total power generation. And for one of the largest economies in the world, China, will lose billions of dollars yearly, affecting their GDP as industries will start to close. The manufacturing industries in most countries will collapse unless alternatives are introduced. And as for the USA, which is some sort of coal, the Saudi Arabia of coal, coal's non-existence will affect its economy. And for those big advertising screens you see in New York, will probably be normal. Our advanced civilizations built on easily exploited coal, oil, and gas. And what will life be like? A world without fossil fuels. Right now, the internet that you are using to watch this video is transferred through fiber cables, which are mostly made from petrochemicals and some metal sourced out of the ground. The device you are using was made with metals pulled out of the ground with diesel gasoline powerful machines. And if you rely on the grid for electricity, you use some of it to charge your device or power your home. Most probably, it has been sourced out of coal, oil, or natural gas. Or maybe you're sipping some wine grown in fertilizer made using natural gas. Talking about the food system, most of the food packaging, preservatives, and ingredients are sourced out from fossil fuels. So in general, a world without fossil fuels would definitely affect the food system globally. On top of creating the climate crisis, banning fossil fuels also creates local air pollution. One kind known as PM2.5 is so small it can actually enter your bloodstream, increasing the risk of death from stroke, heart disease, lung cancer, and respiratory illness among those exposed. Laws like the Clean Air Act have reduced health threats from air pollution since they were enacted in the 1970s, but polluters have fought their way from every step of the way. Tens of thousands of people still die every year from air pollution. We also have clean water. The water pollution story is no better. Time and time again, oil spills and explosions have wreaked havoc on water, land, and homes and communities. Major incidents such as the BP Deepwater Horizon catastrophe, we spilled 4.9 million barrels of oil into the Gulf of Mexico, when bridges, massive tests, and spill show that there is no really safe way to extract, process, or transport fossil fuels. As you can see, where there is drilling, there is spilling. It's one of the issues that has sparked the indigenous-led movement of water protectors, and allies have risen up to oppose risky climate-breaking pipeline projects across the world. And if that weren't enough, coal ash, the byproduct of burning coal in power plants, is incredibly toxic and is often stored in unregulated impounding ponds and can easily leak or spill into waterways. In general, all I can say is that our lives won't be normal anymore and they'll be completely different. And what I mean by this, let's give an example of yourself and let's assume that you're a middle income earner. So it's like this. First thing you do in the morning is to open your eyes with no blankets, a wooden floor or no floor, wooden or stone cutlery, no pillow, no alarm to wake you up, no cell phone, no contact lenses. If you have a poor eyesight, no spectacles. And at some point, maybe you'll be living in a wooden house. You're planning to drive to work, and so no tires, no fuel to power your car, no dashboard. And if you're a farmer, no synthetic pesticides in wood. And without natural gas means no chemical fertilizers to fertilize our fields, which feed half of the world's population. No oil means no airlines that transport 4 billion plus people around the world. No cruise ships that now transport 26 million plus passengers around the world. No merchant ships that move billions of dollars of products throughout the world. And for humans to experience such a life like this one, our daily lives would be completely nothing without fossil fuels, or at some extent they would be boring. By all the facts that I've listed above, it doesn't necessarily mean humankind would be doomed or something like that. Yes, we can survive without fossil fuels by fully utilizing alternatives to sustain ourselves, but the problem is that our generation has adapted this kind of life of using fossil fuels in order to fulfill our daily needs. The hype to eliminate fossil fuels too quickly is allowing 11 million plus children in the world dying every year from preventable causes of malaria, diarrhea, and lack of oxygen at birth. And for those children in poorer countries, do you lack clean drinking water, sewage sanitation, proper nutrition, reliable electricity or any at all? And the projects surrounding us are all based on deep earth minerals and fuels. And once we completely eliminate fossil fuels with no bland breed, these numbers will keep on increasing yearly due to increasing population. You will have to rethink your wardrobe. Your morning routine will change. Some people's health will put at risk because disposable syringes, heart valves and artificial limbs are all petroleum products. And for a fact, did you know that there are over 6,000 products made from petroleum? And that truly shows you how the industry is established. Renewables can only generate electricity at best, and maybe fuel for transportation uses. The indisputable science that renewables cannot manufacture enough oil derivatives, that are the basis of the thousands of projects that are the foundation of societies and economies around the world. And even though coal is a dirty fossil fuel, investors keep on investing millions, if not billions of dollars into the fossil fuel industry. And more tons of coal are dug out of the ground, and more barrels of oil are consumed on a daily basis globally, emitting more emissions into the atmosphere. And even though it leads to more jobs and economic growth, their main concern is profits and not the environment. Climate change is supposed to be our number one priority, but so is economic survivability. China currently builds a new coal-fired power station almost every 2 weeks, but due to the pandemic, these figures might have adjusted a little bit. Economies will collapse, leading to unemployment, zero economic growth, crime, high poverty levels, and the list keeps on going on. And as for natural gas, I can't say much. But in the United States, natural gas is the main feedstock that's then broken down into various elements essential for its economy. Over 96% of all manufactured goods directly touched by the business of chemistry. We wouldn't recognize life without these products. For example, nylon for carpet. Ethylene is used in everything from plastic packaging, housewares and construction products to clothing, insulation, tires and shoes. And methanol goes into gasoline, paints and silicone products. Many of these chemistry products make everyday life not only more convenient, are more sustainable. And while bio-based feedstocks may one day be viable, for now, natural gas is the indispensable ingredient. In 2019, around 84% of the global primary energy came from coal, oil and gas. By energy consumption, I mean that this is the sum of all energy uses, including electricity, transport and heating. Fossil fuels can generate a large amount of electricity at a single location. Fossil fuels have massive economic benefits. It's no brainer that fossil fuels might contribute to a country's prosperity. If you look at the economies of oil and gas producing countries, you see a common trend: economic prosperity. Government subsidies to oil firms range in billions of dollars, and the contribution to the growth of a country is more than convincing. If you start considering how many countries across the world greatly rely on fossil fuels, the number of industries powered by them, and the number of products that would not be available right now without them, you begin to understand just how fossil fuels have permeated our day-to-day life. They create jobs. There's no doubt that fossil fuels have created numerous jobs in the fields of finance, administration, and construction. Fossil fuels generate hundreds of thousands of jobs every year. To just abandon the use of fossil fuels now would lead to lots of people being jobless, which could seriously affect economies all over the world. This demonstrates that the fossil fuel energy sector is a solid source of employment. Fossil fuels just make everything in the world move. We've come to realize that a world without fossil fuels would be a different world, similar to the life that was before the Industrial Revolution, where manpower and road power and wild fruits was their norm. Ever wondered where most people lose most of their money, with thousands, if not millions of dollars, and at some point, with just an action of a tap, and the other, the use of dice and cards? I think you guessed it, betting and gambling. And that's what we are going to be talking about in our next video.